to hear the preaching of the Word of God.
Amen.
And we are so blessed that the Lord allows him to come for us to be challenged by the Word of God. And I am so glad to introduce to you our guest speaker for today. Our guest speaker is the husband of one wife.
Amen.
Right. One wife.
Amen.
And that is Ma'am Delia Estepona. Ma'am, will you please stand? She's in Ilocana. Okay. Pareho po kami ng salita. Huwag na po kayong mababahala dahil si Pastor Pop ay taga-Bicol din naman. Masaya sila. Ilonggo, wala yata ngayon. They've been married for 30 years. The father of two, Brother Jonathan and Brother Joseph, 27 years old and 21 years old. Our guest speaker was saved by the grace of God through faith in the Lord Jesus Christ in February 18, 1982. How young is he now? And began serving the Lord. For 34 years now, in 1985 to 1987, he was the assistant pastor of Pastor Melvin Brown in La Loma Baptist Church, Quezon City. In 1987, Pastor Brown turned over to him the church at the age of 25 from 1987 to 1996. And after 1996, he turned over La Loma Baptist Church to Pastor Gilbert Toquero. Kilala po natin siya. And in 1996 to 2000, he became the pastor of Central Baptist Church in San Carlos, Pangasinan, and became evangelist also. And at present, from 2000 to present, he is the pastor of Hebron Baptist Church, Cainta, Rizal. Sino pong mga taga Rizal dito? Wala yata. I didn't ask our guest speaker what is his motivation or drives him in serving the Lord. But one thing I know for sure, that he loves the Lord.
Amen.
Wala na po akong sabihin mahaba. And let us welcome our guest speaker for our 6th World Mission Conference. Our guest speaker, Pastor Emmanuel Estepona, pastor of Hebron Baptist Church, California.
Good morning po sa bawat isa. He asked yung motivation, the privilege to serve the Lord.
Yeah.
Before I got saved, the world and the devil used my life. So now, why could I not give it to the Lord to use my life?
Amen.
So I, in 1984, in a Wednesday prayer meeting, two Bible school students preached, and I surrendered my life to serve the Lord. So that started the my service for the Lord. And while in college, in our college, there were this youth who always go on a rally. Uprising. And they would shout in Tagalog for the youth, "Kung hindi ngayon, kailan? Kung hindi tayo, sino? If not now, when? If not us, who?" And I said, here are these people giving their life for a cause. So why can't I give my life to the Lord?
Amen.
So one of the motivating reason, no? I was 22 that time. So if I have to wait later on, if I get old, then I might not be able to serve. Something, maybe I'm already sick or what. So why not I give my life now? So I gave my life 1984. And it's also an honor and privilege to introduce my wife of 30 years. And I told Pastor Brown, this one, I followed the Lord scripturally. I married my neighbor. Because the Bible says, love your neighbor. But only one neighbor. Okay? Only one. I would request Delia to stand up. Yeah. Delia. Thank you. I'm happy that she came with me dito sa pag-preach. Siya ang aking dilaylay. Siya ang nagpabagsak sa akin. I mean, yung to serve the Lord, helping in the ministry. Okay, I was introduced to missions in 1982, no? When I came to La Loma Baptist Church. That was, I got saved in February 18, 1982. And La Loma Baptist Church World Missions Conference is always at the end of February, the last week of February. The church was started in 1980. So we arrived there, my wife and I arrived there in 1982. So just those who have listened to the testimony of my wife, I got saved in February 18. And then February 24, I went out giving tracts. And I saw them, her twin sister, and I gave them a tract and asked them if they're sure about to go to heaven. So I witnessed to them. So she got saved February 24, 6 days. Now, I did not witness just to find the wife, Pastor. I was obeying the Lord to witness it. Not knowing later on, after Bible school in 1985, that she would be the one. So, hindi yung reason what I was witnessing to find the girlfriend or wife. Just following the Lord. So, any pace to witness and develop drugs, no? So, during that time, the church was 2 years old. And just a few weeks in, you've been hearing about these missions, world missions, of preaching the world for Christ. So from that time, that already introduced us to reach the world. And if I could not be the one, then how would I help in this world missions? So by starting to help in the church, whatever is available for me to help, so to help in the church. Eh? And my first chore there is an usher, you know, fixing the chairs, after the service. And one young people said, why are you doing that? Why? There's already a caretaker. There was an apartment and Pastor Brown had a caretaker there and he was the one fixing the chairs. So the young people said, why are you doing that? We're paying somebody to do that. And I said, why couldn't I not do it, even though if I'm not being paid? I wanted to serve the Lord. So I started the chairs, and then later on, a driver in the church, Pastor Brown, got a vehicle, and he asked me if I could drive. I said, yes, I have a driver's license. And I want you to drive the church vehicle, fetching people. And it was the happiest moment in my life that I thought I could die anytime, even inside that vehicle, serving the Lord. So I thought that was my ministry my whole life, a driver. But then as the Lord opened, teaching children, teaching youth, and then Sunday school, and then assistant pastor, not knowing later on that he would nationalize the world. He asked me to pray about it, my wife, and he said, why? Why in a Filipino? I wanted to nationalize it. So you pray about it, and so in 1987, we became the pastor. And Pastor Toquero was our neighbor. So he came to church, and then his first chores were deaf. Sign language, and then he's good at music, piano. And then later on, he became my assistant. And then when we transferred in 1996, I endorsed him to be the next pastor. So up to now, our friendship is still there. And I support him. And we are partners for world missions.
Amen.
And together with Pastor Cabahar. And Pastor Cabahar is our neighbor also. So we live in the same street, no? So three pastors plus another pastor, my classmate in college, also became a pastor. So in that same street, God called for pastors. So it's a privilege to serve the Lord. And this is the first time I'm invited outside the Philippines. So I was telling Pastor John, this is the first time. Eh? So it's good your pulpit is wide enough to cover my knees. Nervous. Nervous. Eh? At, so it's an honor and privilege to have a part in your World Missions Conference.
Amen.
Thank you so much for the warm welcome. Actually, the very hot welcome. Because the moment we came out of the airport, very, very hot. We usually tell visiting American missionaries, we have two climates here, hot and hotter. Here it's hotter and hottest. I don't know if that's good grammar. So thank you for the hot welcome that you gave us. And the accommodation, Pastor, very nice. We stay in a nice place, a holiday villa. And mayroon pang basket of fruits. At and the pastor has given so many gifts, no? At blessings. And I pray that the Lord would bless you also abundantly.
Amen.
For your wonderful accommodation to us. No? And yes, bless your church tremendously in your parts of world missions. No? And it's very unusual yung inyong case dahil you meet on a Friday. Typically, the Philippines nga, di ba? Sunday. But then in Hebrews 10:25, it does not say there what day. Not to forsake the assembling of ourselves together.
Amen.
As long as we meet together any day, we meet together. We obey the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
So it doesn't matter the day. Sa Philippines, if the government bans the church going on a Sunday, then we will meet on a Saturday. Then we would be Seventh-day Baptists. But we will still meet. Diba? So it's not the day. It's obeying the Lord what day that we meet together. Amen? So I salute you na you still meet even though on this day. No? At, and then you've been blessed financially in a foreign land to support world mission. So, Pastor has shared yung part nyo sa world mission. No? At talagang tremendous yung support nyo, no? Para sa mga missionaries at local and foreign. At the same time, maintaining a good Christian and family testimony sa isang bansa na kaiba, different from what we used to be, no? Nung nandun kayo sa Pilipinas, no? So, both ways, no? A testimony and supporting missions. And helping establish a work for God until He keeps it for His purpose. To some, maybe longer. You are saying here, maybe by contract or shorter, whatever the Lord leads.
Amen.
So if your work ends, natapos na yung work mo, either by contract or circumstantially, or as the Lord intervenes, that He might want you to help in some place.
Amen.
Doing the same thing, katulad ginawa nga to. Whether UAE, Dubai, Abu Dhabi, we do not know. So, it is the place where God has shown you and then start another work also in this area of the world. As I look at it while talking to Pastor Giano, I look at you as modern-day Joseph and Daniels. Because you work in a foreign land and you work under rulers who may not be have the same belief. But you work as consultants. So as you go up, one day, they may ask you for some advice. And because of God's wisdom, they will be amazed.
Amen.
And ask you about your God.
Amen.
See, both did not just tell the rulers, Daniel and Joseph, about their God. Until there was a problem in the country, and the rulers were the ones who got Daniel and Joshua. And they found out, that Daniel said, there is a God in heaven.
Amen.
See, so it's a different way around it. God will bless you as you go up. I remember in college, when you want to witness to the magna cum laude, summa cum laude, they would not want to talk to you dahil you're not the same as them intelligent. So, yung mga ganun, for candidates, for may title. No? So I told the Lord, no, if I would witness to them, then they would see that you would also give the wisdom. So God gave you good grades, eh. So you went up, and then now they're talking to you, thinking that you also have this insight, but only to be able to talk to them. So one of these the magna cum laude, I asked her, where did you come from? From monkeys. I said, you're studying science and you came from monkeys. I came from God. And he asked, what are you, Estebona? Oh, I'm a Christian. That's what the Bible says. Eh? If you were to die today, do you know for sure? No. Could you tell me? So now you could share to them. So that's what I see sa inyong party. If you be a good Christian, honest and hardworking, you will be promoted, you go up. And the Lord might use you just about yung rulers sa place na ito to be consultants and ask for wisdom. So that's why our family life also is very important as the Lord prepares us and trains us. Especially in the area of family life and our belief. Today, you're taking up your faith promise commitment for world missions. And usually, some unusual things have happened in our lives every missions conference. That's always something happens, ano? So we might be distracted and not concentrate our faith in the Lord. So, in a little way, the relationships that we have in our families would be a way, you know, to help us trust the Lord. This is where He has brought us. And maybe later on, He has something for us. As the blessing of the Lord has given to you here, no, your faith has been commendable. No, the base of the faith promise commitment is faith. Believing God. As you know, in our country, they would say we're third world. But actually, not eh, because of the economy. No, and they would say, oh, it cannot happen to us. So, tayo, especially lang sa preacher to teach, God can, kaya ng Diyos eh. See, ako'y testimony sa Filipino from an American na nagsasabi, oh, the reason why, because there was an American. But the God of the American and His Bible is the same.
Amen.
So He preached that Bible and I would preach from that Bible.
Amen.
So God can use us.
Amen.
Kaya ko doon sa mga Filipino. Ha? So, we teach on faith. The same way, we have some friends, African friends, when you go back someday to your country, then you will be the one that will make a difference.
Amen.
You might think, well, who am I? Then that's a familiar phrase in the Bible. Moses said that, who am I? But then God said, I want to use you.
Amen.
So the same way, the faith, either individually or by couple or by family, the Lord can initiate a change in your status someday. You cannot say, not me, Lord, but if the Lord says, I want you. We go where God wants us to go.
Amen.
The Apostle Paul, a persecutor of Christians in Acts 9:6, Lord, what wilt thou have me to do? The Apostle Paul did not have a burden for Christians. He was persecuting Christians. Eh? And then he got saved and then immediately asked, where wilt thou have me? Where wilt thou have me to do, Lord? So the same way, if the Lord would lead you to serve for Him, to reach a race or a people, the burden follows later. So some would think that, well, I don't have a burden for them. But we have the Word of God.
Amen.
We obey God first. So whatever He would say, then we obey. At first, we may not understand. But as we obey, you would see the burden that God would give. Remember in Matthew 9, when the Lord came to a place, when He saw, then He had the compassion. He saw first. Eh? So we have to obey first. So God will do what He says He will do. He will keep His promise. And let me share to you a way in where God said something and did His part in the life of Abraham. So let's open our Bible in Genesis chapter 15. follow as I read. Starting verse 1, after this stage, the word of the Lord came unto Abraham in a vision, saying, Fear not, Abraham, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward. And Abraham said, Lord God, what wilt thou give me, seeing I go childless, and the steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus? And Abraham said, Behold, to me thou hast given no seed, and though one born in my house is mine heir. And behold, the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, This shall not be thine heir, but he that shall come forth out of thine own bowels shall be thine heir. And he brought him forth abroad and said, Look now toward heaven, and tell the stars, if thou be able to number them. And he said unto him, So shall thy seed be. And he believed in the Lord, and he counted it unto him for righteousness. And he said unto him, I am the Lord that brought thee out of the Ur of the Chaldees, to give thee this land to inherit it. And he said, Lord God, whereby shall I know that I shall inherit it? And he said unto him, Take me an heifer of 3 years old, and a she-goat of 3 years old, a ram of 3 years old, and a turtle dove, and a young pigeon. And he took unto him all this, and divided them in the midst, and laid each piece one against another. But the birds divided he not. And when the fowls came down upon the carcasses, Abraham drove them away. And when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon Abraham, and lo, an horror of a great darkness fell upon him. And he said unto Abraham, Know of a surety that thy seed shall be a stranger in a land that is not theirs, and shall serve them, and they shall afflict them 400 years. And also that nation whom they shall serve will I judge, and afterward shall they come out with great substance. And thou shalt go to thy fathers in peace, thou shalt be buried in a good old age. But in the fourth generation they shall come hither again, for the iniquity of the Amorites is not yet full. It came to pass that when the sun went down, and it was dark, behold, a smoking furnace and a burning lamp that passed by between those pieces. In the same day the Lord made a covenant with Abraham, saying, Unto thy seed have I given this land, from the river of Egypt unto the great river, the river Euphrates. Kenites, the Kenizzites, the Kadmonites, the Hittites and the Perizzites, the Rephaimites, the Amorites, the Canaanites, and the Girgashites, and the Jebusites. Ay, pamanalangin, let's pray, Father, again, aling namin ang inyong paggabay, ang inyong paghahanda ay nagawa nyo na, at dalangin naman namin na ang paggabay ng inyong Banal na Espiritu sa aming kalagitnaan. And we are pinapasalamatan na, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. So faith is believing what God says in His Word. Sa inyong team ng making a difference, no? May kakaiba na pwedeng gawin ka. To us, thinking na some have done great things, at what can I do more? Usually, yung difference, it depends yung difference, whether it's small. Usually we think of inches or centimeters. But do you know, sa spaceship, a small difference is very important, eh. Kapag hindi sukat o it would not match yung isang ano, magka-cause yan ng disaster. Just a small difference. Kaya, to people thinking, yung small, or whether we think we are small, or small, nobody recognizes us, well, God makes the difference.
Amen.
Siya ang gagawa ng kakaiba, eh.
Amen.
Hindi naman yung tayo, what we can do. So, let's look here at development of Abraham's faith. So, yung, dito yung part nito ng nagbigay ng assurance ang Diyos kay Abraham about yung calling niya na of being a nation. And Abraham prepared his servants maging na bago pa before na he would go to the promised land. Sa chapter 14, papakita natin dyan sa verse 14, when Abraham heard that his brother was taken captive, he armed his trained servants born in his own house, 318, and pursued them unto Dan, na-kidnap eh, yung mga kamag-anakan ni Abraham. And he divided himself against them, he and his servants, by night and smote them. Sabihin, nag-prepare na si Abraham eh. Na before nangyari pa yung ganun, he prepared them already. So may tiwala siya na kahit po konti, they were only a few eh. Ang kalaban nung marami eh. But he prepared them, no? Nagtiwala siya na kailangan maganda siya. Kasi ang sabi, it says sa verse chapter 15, verse 1, after these things, ito yan, he was separated from Lot, his nephew, and then binigay niya yung tithe sa chapter 14, verse 20, is unselfishness of not taking everything God has not given. sinong sinakit niya, yung king, binigyan siya ng madami. And Abraham did not accept that. Kaya ngayon, after these things, ang reward niya came from God.
Amen.
Nung he did not accept, dahil sabi ng Panginoon sa verse 1, chapter 15, I am thy shield and thy exceeding great reward.
Amen.
Ganun na unselfish si Abraham eh. So God assured him of three things. His presence, sabi sa kanya, fear not. His protection, thy shield, I am thy shield. His provision, I am the exceeding great reward. So kung balang araw, tawagin ka ng Panginoon, nag-mission o saan ka tawagin, wherever He would call you, the same. God keeps His word. No? He does not do it just for Abraham, Moses, sino mang He used in the Bible. But if you give your life to God, He keeps His promises.
Amen.
He even had the trial of weakness of faith. So verse 23, we read that he was asking God that, I am childless. Here he was promised that he would be an heir, that he would have an heir, and where's the child? And then he had a servant, si Eliezer, so he thought that was yung magiging inheritance niya. What will thou give me? Ang tanong niya, I go childless. Oh, wala ako. Iniisip natin malang araw, if God would use us, what can I do? Eh, for now, pwede natin isipin. But if we would trust God, He can do something, no? Even greater things that we know not.
Amen.
The same, sabi niya, I'm childless. How can I be yung mag-i-inherit? Eh, wala na akong child. Sabi pa niya sa Panginoon, sa verse 3, thou was given no seed, o yung anak. But we must remember, first of all, God gave the command in chapter 12. As we go back sa chapter 12, nung verse 1, sinabi, now the Lord had said unto Abraham, get thee out of thy country, from thy kindred, from thy father's house, unto a land that I will show thee. So sinabihan siya to get thee out, to come out from his country. And I will make of thee, see, it was the Lord who will make him. I will make of thee a great nation, I will bless thee, make thy name great, and thou shalt be a blessing. So the command was already given, inutos sa kanya eh. Secondly, we see the promises God gave to Abraham. It's a verse 3 na He will provide, He will be a blessing. Maraming binanggit dyan sa verse 2 and 3 na ngayong mga promises, no? So, there are always promises when we obey God.
Amen.
Typical na that we use sa pagka-mission, and my God shall supply all your King James ba ang gamit nyo? And my God shall supply all your pa rin eh. May narinig pa rin akong siwit. And my God shall supply all your
need.
Walang S. Walang S. Kasi nauna yung all. That means by priority yun. So, kung ikaw may anak, the child will be provided first. See? Tayo, we may not eat for a while, but the child has to eat. So, the child goes first. Kaya by priority yun. All your need. Kaya walang S. Okay? Kaya kung isipin natin, well, how about yung aking ano? Well, God will provide.
Amen.
In Hebrews 13:5, and I'll never leave thee nor forsake thee.
Amen.
Sapat na yung dalawa na yun. To provide and to protect us. It's like God saying to Abraham, I will bring you to where you will be blessed and be a blessing. Sino sinabi kay Abraham? Get thee out to a land, and later on sa Hebrews, not knowing which land ba eh. Imagine mo nga daw yun, sabi ng Panginoon, get thee out of place to a land that I will show thee. So, nag-impake si Abraham, and he was going out, and he was asked, where are you going? Sa ating Tagalog, dyan lang. Wala pa, hindi pa alam eh. But he had that faith that I will go as the Lord leads.
Amen.
Eh, pinagpala, you've been blessed here so much sa BBC, and you have been a blessing around the world. At times, isipin mo na malayo ka, maybe sa plano ng Panginoon, dito ka muna blinis para maging blessing. Meron akong youngest sister na nag-work sa abroad din, sa Hong Kong muna. At ang number one na hinarap niya is loneliness. Ang kalungkutan. Siya is single, no? Typical, usually when you go out, eh. Yung kalungkutan sa loved ones, eh. pero thinking na may paraan ng Diyos that I would be a blessing for him. Magtiwala ka lang. So God reminds Abraham of his promise. Balikan nyo dyan sa chapter 15. So yun yung binagit sa kanya sa Genesis 12. So God had just to remind him, the verse 4, and behold, the word of the Lord came unto him saying, this shall not be thine heir. Hindi yan, no? Yung magiging heir niya. Meron siyang descendants talaga that God has prepared. And the land that he will inherit. So, God does not just bless us materially or financially just for ourselves. Hindi para sa atin lang yan. It is for His purpose for us to be channels of blessing. Amen. Hindi lang dahil sa galing natin yan. Eh. It is the Lord who gave yung blessing.
Amen.
Fourthly, Abraham asked assurance if he will receive his inheritance. Paano naman siya? Verse 8, he said, Lord God, whereby shall I know that I shall inherit it? Kaya nagtanong din eh, no? Typical, no? At times na, how will I know how you would use me, Lord? Typical, no? That we would ask usually, how? But he had to wait at paripaliwanag ng Diyos, ano? Yung susunod dyan, yung sa letter E, God laid out the first contract signing. Sa Israel na inintroduce ng Diyos, ano? Magkaano ka dyan, you will get yung animals, ilalatag mo dito sa isang side. Yung other animal dito, yung heifer, no? Female calf yan eh. Kakatayin mo, paghihiwalayin mo. Ito ay traditional sa mga Israelites. If you have an agreement, ganun ang gagawin nila, no? You kill an animal here and the other side. And then you go in the middle, pupunta ka sa gitna, hand in hand. Ibig sabihin, you will do your part dun sa agreement when you go in the middle. Yan ang setup nila noon. Kaya nung pinakuha siya nung red heifer, siya nagpasimula na pinakakontrata yung agreement of God with Abraham. Pero, what happened there, no? Sa F, Abraham's faith was tested by waiting. Sa verse 11, verse 10, he took unto him all these, divided them in the midst, laid each piece one against another. But the birth divided he not. When the fowls came down upon the carcasses, Abraham drove them away. Yung mga kakain doon sana sa mga animal, so pinapalis niya. Eh ano daw? Hanggang kailan siya hiwi? Verse 12, when the sun was going down. So from morning up to night, he had to wait what God will do. Eh. Kaya nga, isinushew niya yung mga birds. Eh. So he had to wait. Ano ang gagawin ng Diyos doon sa pinagawa sa kanya? Ano? Hindi kakalagay dyan sa ano. God is never late. And yet at times, He wants us to wait.
Amen.
Hindi nalilate ang Diyos. Kaya kung tatanim mo, hanggang gaano katagal, how long? Well, magantay-antay ka, alam ng Diyos. No? Usually, by contract, then malalaman mo. If your contract ends, then tapos na isang part sa buhay mo. Sa isang elementary o high school, after yung elementary o high school, you graduate in college. So you will know. But at times, you have to wait. Aantayin mo. So he had to wait. And then, ang sabi doon, verse 12, when the sun was going down, a deep sleep fell upon Abraham, and lo and horror of darkness fell upon him. Ito yung mamaya, papakita yung future sa kanya. Anong ginawa ng Panginoon doon? No? Verse 17, it came to pass that when the sun went down, it was dark, behold, a smoking furnace and a burning lamp that passed between those pieces. Dalawa, dumaan sa gitna. A burning furnace, a smoking furnace, and a burning lamp. So in an agreement, yung two person would go sa gitna. But this time, Abraham was asleep. So yung commitment to agree dun sa commitment, only God went in the middle. Yung signifying yung smoking furnace, ang description of God, at saka yung burning lamp. So yung condition was dependent upon God. So he was the one who only went into the middle. Eh. Si Abraham was asleep. Eh. So, hindi man makasunod si Abraham or he committed sin in his life, God would not change the agreement dahil God was the one who went in the middle at inako niya yung agreement. Kaya, anything might happen sa yung life, nag-wait ka, something goes wrong, years will pass, But still God would do what He wants His will.
Amen.
Remember Pastor saying na si Brother Ronnie ay ako daw ang nagbaptize. Brother Jimmy. I could not remember. Kasi may Alzheimer's ako eh. Hindi pa Alzheimer's, Alzheimer's. Kaya meron akong excuse for not memorizing verse. May Alzheimer's ako eh. Yung isang father, sabi niya, tayo mga fathers, exempted na sa memorization. Ako may Alzheimer's, kaya hindi ako memorize. So years has passed. Ngayon, dito, napunta sa Qatar. And then, tumutulong sa gawain. Amen?
Amen.
So, commitment ang Diyos sa buhay ng isang man that I have to use. Kahit gaano katagal yan, andyan ang Diyos eh. He will fulfill His word. So, God revealed the future to Abraham. So, yun na yun, no? Yung bondage na mangyayari. See, the nation was not yet being established. And yet, God showed Abraham a great nation already going into bondage. Imagine mo yun, na hindi pa nabubuo, and yet God showed him. And at times, God would reveal the wisdom ng what we would foresee na mangyayari sa atin. Ito yung tatrabaho, I will work here, I will finish. And then, may nakikita ka eh, that God might open here, God might open there. E, pwede niyang gawin yun eh. Description that God showed us, a horror of great darkness. There will be some dark night in our lives also as believers. Magkakaroon tayo ng mga mabibigat na trial. Pero hindi pa rin magbabago ang plano ng Diyos. Sometimes the waiting that God wants us to do is letting Him do His will in His time. Sometimes yung waiting, ganun. Meron niyang kanyang timing. As I shared, na maybe someday you'll get a bigger place. Amen? Oh, bigger place. Para mag-meet in His time. We visited a missionary, but I was not a speaker there. We just visited a missions conference sa Beijing. Imagine mo, Beijing, sa center ng China. There's a place that looks like this, a meeting place. Mataas lang ang ceiling, high ceiling, with also posts ng ganyan. Big red curtain sa paligid. And they have a meeting place sa center ng Beijing. One of the caretakers there, kasi may mga factory doon eh, being managed by yung sasabing member ng Communist Party. So yung member na yon got saved and he was handling yung meeting place. Parang yung mga pag meron kang meetings. So when he got saved, he offered yung place for them to be. He was the caretaker eh. So God transferred them to that place. And maybe someday, you become a caretaker of a big place. And God would use you.
Amen.
And wala nang, usually we hear that nothing is impossible with God eh. Amen. But you just look how God would do that eh. Na magugulat ka. So, yung waiting na yan, we just let Him do His will in His time. Alam na alam ng Panginoon niya. No? Even in death ni Abraham was prophesied by God. Hindi pa great nation, ano sabi sa kanya? Thou shalt be buried in a good old age. From beginning to end, God has already prepared yung plano para sa kanya. The age God signed the contract with Abraham, yeah, not walking between the sacrifice animals. Yun na, ang pirma ng Diyos. His word. Itong salita na ito. God says something there, He says what He will do. Kailangan lang magtiwala ka. Nasa salita ng Diyos siya. It's in His word. What God says, He will do.
Amen.
God told Abraham the scope of the promised land and ibinigay yung mga nations ng enemies that He will defeat. So, sinabi sa kanya nung una, nagkaroon siya ng doubt, but still, pinaprove ng Panginoon na gagawin niya talaga yun. Ngayon, tingin natin yung application niya sa missions. We have the command to reach the world. Merong promise, Lo, I am with you always. His power, His presence, protection, provision. He gives His assurance, even unto the end of the world.
Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Meron pa sa Acts 1:8, and ye shall be witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, and unto the uttermost. Ang uttermost, He will supply. So tayo na lang magsusulat dun eh. His part sa word, ating part yung sa commitment. So para tayo nag-contract signing. And I will support yung World Mission Project ng BBC for 1 year. Sulat natin ninyo. And God does His word. I am with you always. And we wait on God daily and weekly for our needs. And we know the future. Ayon sa Matthew 24, just before the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, the tribulation period, binigay na sa Matthew 24. Ang ginagawa na lang natin ay inaantay na gawin natin ang ating gagawin. The Lord Jesus will come back from us, from heaven one day, and after doing, we have our part sa world missions. So God keeps His word. Yung ginamit sa Jude ng making a difference of helping just somebody to keep them out of the fire, pulling them out of the fire. We make a difference in one's life, no, sa isang buhay. Kahit nasaan tayo, nasa ibang malayong lugar tayo. Kaya, as you gawa ng commitment mo, God will keep His word. Isusupply niya ang ating need. And if God would want to use you, hindi ko lang someday, baka at time, it might be already, at this time, na may sinasabi na sa'yo, then He will keep His word. He will supply our needs, and He will never leave us nor forsake us. That's why. Nakilakamahan muli na, nakaiba nga na, bilang isang amang kataya sa aming lahi na gamitin nyo sa ibang lugar, ito yung aming mga kaibigan na sa ibang bansa that you use them, Panginoon. Kayo nakakalam din sa mga taong nandun. Kailangan lang magtiwala sa inyong salita. Papasalamat na muli sa inyong pagkilos sa aming kalagitnaan. As we bow our heads, I'd like to call the question.
Every head bowed, please. Every head closed. No one looking around. We heard a very simple message this morning, reminding us that God keeps His word. God keeps His word. The God of Abraham is also our God. The God who kept His word during Abraham's days, the same God that we believe today. You have His word. I have His word. His promise that He will be with us. His promise of His presence. The Lord will never leave us. He will never forsake us. The promise of His protection. He will protect you physically. He will protect your family. He will even protect your child. God can do that. God can do that. God can give you a job better than the job that you have now. And God's promise of provision. The Bible says, God says, but my God shall supply all your need according to His riches in glory by Christ Jesus. My question for you this morning is, do you have the faith to believe that God keeps His word? Do you doubt God at times? Folks, we are reminded with the word of God today that God keeps His word. Whatever God says, God never lies. He cannot lie. He always keeps His word. He kept His word. He fulfilled His promise to Abraham, and He too will fulfill His promise to you and I. While every head are bowed and eyes are closed, no one looking around, who will say this morning, Pastor, please pray for me. God spoke to my heart this morning. God spoke to my heart. Pray for me. That I will have the faith to believe in the word of God, that God will always keep His word. Will you raise your hand? Let me see. God bless you. Very good response. I will pray. And then when we pray, after we pray, we will stand. Brother Jemmer will play the piano softly. You come to the front today. Ask the Lord to impress upon your heart how much He wants you to give to missions this year. And thank Him for His promises. Thank God who is faithful in every promise He made. God is always true. Lord, we thank You for Pastor and Mrs. Estepon, and thank You, Lord, for the many years of service that they have rendered to You. Those years is an indication that You are faithful, that You have kept them, You have Your presence is always with them, that You have provided for them. Lord, thank You that You sent them here to our church to speak to us and to challenge us and to give us Your message. Lord, thank You for the reminder that we heard from Your word today, that You are always true to Your word, that You keep Your word. Lord, I pray that every believer, every Christian here today will keep that message in their heart, that we should never be afraid, to make a commitment because we have your word, we have your promise, and that you will always fulfill your word, your promise, including providing for our needs, not just for ourselves, but the finances that is needed to give to missions. Lord, bless this time of invitation. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Shall we all stand? Everybody stand. Would you come right now? This will not be a long invitation.